I had a message the other day. Somebody had commented on the old style 66 bobbin winder. They said that they had an older style, but not as old as that one, and they needed a little help with it, and determined it was the style where the cam is behind the in front and behind the gear instead of in front. And yeah, it's a little different. Actually, do I have? Let me look on my pile of stuff here on the bench. See if I still have. Yeah, this is nope. That's the wrong one. This here is the other one. It's very similar. The only difference really is the cam is on the back, but we'll take it apart anyway. What the heck. So the only thing we need for this is a this is a number 95 Chapman screwdriver bit, and for some reason the 9/32 doesn't fit. The 5/16 is just a little large, but we'll use the 5/16 ignition wrench anyway. It's pretty close, so we'll just start off by loosening that nut, actually taking that nut off the back and removing the eccentric bolt and the big gear, and of course the domed washer fell out at the same time. And then we'll take off the cam follower slash thread guide, and its screw is going to come out along with it. This is a little different than the sequence I did the other one on. Doesn't really matter if you take this portion off first or if you take this off second. When I say first and second, I mean after you take the rest of that off. We're just going to do this end first, just to be a little different. So we've got that off, and we'll pull out the spring. There's its little coil spring. Okay, let's take the bobbin follower with the locking arm off next. Okay, and away it goes the spring. And we'll take off the bobbin winder assembly itself. Conveniently, none of this has really changed position in my left hand very much. Okay, there's the main bolt. There's the spring. All these parts, if you watch the other video, should look very, very familiar. And then we remove the bracket. By the way, this particular bobbin winder came off of a model 99 that I've got. Okay, there's all the parts. I really don't feel like polishing this right now, so let's just pretend that I polished all these parts. All right. Just like we did on the last one, I'm going to take the pivot bolt for the the main bobbin winder itself, and put that into the belt guard. So that this is all the way, the screw is all the way down. It's only in temporarily. Then we're going to put the locking screw for the adjustment in. And we're going to get the adjustment about halfway through its cycle, because that's a good place to start. You're going to have to adjust it when it gets on the machine anyway, and this is your adjustment point. But if we get this in and we get that nice and locked, when it comes time to put this part on, the hole in this bracket that is now screwed onto the belt guard is properly oriented so that when we go to screw this in place, that's all going to be lined up and it'll be easy to thread in place. Okay, I hope you can forgive me. I was just working on editing the footage down, and I noticed that I had pulled out a camera shot. So, we start with the bobbin winder itself. Now, this has already been assembled. I'll use the earlier footage when I'm actually putting these parts on, but for the moment, ignore the fact that they're there. All right, the pin on the spring goes into the hole that is located down here. Okay? The pin goes in. Don't worry too much about where the position of that spring is at the moment. Run the bolt in through the back. Now, that spring that's hanging out is going to be acting against this portion of the bracket. So we have to kind of put it on kind of a little bit out of its comfort zone. We have to get that spring kind of scooched up against that and then bring this over and then run the screw in. I'm hoping this is clear. Okay, we've got it started. Or I should say we've got it in position. We're working against the spring right now. And this is why we wanted everything lined up with that bracket. Because now it's in. Now we have the spring action. And I'm going to assume that my other footage where I was putting the bobbin follower on was messed up too. So there's two pieces of wire that are protruding off of the spring that's on the bobbin follower. One is close aboard the coil, which is this one here, and the other is protruding out a little bit. The one that's close aboard the coil goes into the bracket thusly. Okay? Now, there's only one hole on the follower. We will put the other end, the other protrusion portion, into there. We're just going to get the screw started. Now it's got a shoulder. Ooh, somebody did chew that up. Get it started, but it's still a little floppy. Okay, see, that's still a little floppy like that. We're going to use that floppiness to our advantage. We're going to bring the follower over while we move the bobbin winder itself down until the follower locks into the bobbin winder. And seeing how we've already got the screw started on the shoulder, that allows us to get that in a position and we can tighten that up a little bit. And then you'll see we have good action on that. All right, let's go back and I'll show you how this stuff goes on. Next victim, let's go ahead. There's once again one hole in there. We will put our spring in, get the spring into the hole, because that's so much fun. All right, yeah. Now, there's a right way and a wrong way on the spring, I should point out. Let's see if I can get this so you can see. You can see how the coil is very close on this side to the protrusion is very close to the coil, and on the opposite side here it sticks out. Well, where it's sitting very close to the coil, that's the one that goes in the hole. You'll never make it work if you put the wrong side of the spring in. So yes, it does matter. And wiggle it so it goes in there. Now, we will put the hole in the thread guide slash cam follower is off to the side. So we're going to stick the other piece of the wire in there and get the longish screw in. And run that down a little bit. Actually, run that down all the way. And now, you see, we've got a lot of spring action on that. All right. Putting the concave side down. Then we put the wheel in position. Put the eccentric shaft through. And you may have to wiggle it a little bit to get it in. It's in. And then start the screw in the back by hand. And just get it kind of finger tight. And then just adjust your lash in the gears, because once again, this is an eccentric screw. See here, I've got it, so it's not even engaging. So if I keep turning it, it will eventually, that engages too much. So we do the delicate dance, the balancing act once again. And there we go. It's got just the right amount of lash. And then, oops. You got to be careful. Okay, that's perfect. Now here's the tricky part. You got to try to hold that screw so it doesn't turn while you tighten the nut. It's a little difficult to do. Sometimes it helps to have an extra person. But there, I got it, and we got just the right amount of lash. So that's it. Yeah, pretty simple. I did get my other one painted, by the way, for those who are following on the tractor paint. This is International Harvester Red. That's a balance wheel that's going to go on to this 66. Also coming up, there's going to be a 201-2 in this color. We'll talk about that another time. But anyway, that's it for this particular bobbin winder. I'm going to go throw this back on my 99, and I hope that helps you, and we will see you on the next one, and thank you so much for watching.